The Way Home or Face the Fire: The Survival Plan for All Human Plus Beings. Chapter 8: The Shining Example, The Light of the World. Individual socialism from a personal choice is the only way, Jesus. You did not come here to have a good time, which usually means a bad time, and collect material wealth. You are in prison, on death row, and you came here to learn to be good, earn your pardon and right to go home, or, if not, be executed. Jesus used, quote, the force to work miracles in the new covenant. When you have, quote, blind faith, which does not really mean blind, it means 100% total faith in God, with your eyes, human and spiritual, wide open to all the angles from which Satan can use people to attack you, you can then become a channel for, quote, the force. If you do not have blind faith, you block the channel, and the force can neither flow through you nor into you to heal you. Quote, the force came from God and flowed through Jesus, and he directed it into the people who had unblocked channels, blind faith, and the force cured them. God, through Jesus, only cured the people who had total faith that Jesus was his Son, incarnated, and that he could cure them. Your 100% faith in God's power and in me has made you whole, and your sins from your previous lifetime, which caused you to be blind, crippled, or sick as a punishment in this lifetime, are forgiven you. Go and sin no more. John 9:2. And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Are your channels unblocked yet? Faith is the key to the, quote, magic door, the door to miracles and a God-guided life. Walking always in the healing light and the entrance to the kingdom of God and the return to your immortality, real memory, identity, and superhuman powers. Samson used the force to pull down the heathen temple. David's stone was guided by the force to kill Goliath. The force parted the Red Sea, etc., etc., etc. Jesus was transfigured on the mountain, and his face shone like the sun, because his soul, being of light, chapter 1, was shining through his face like Moses. And his clothes were white and shining, quote, as white as the light, and whiter than anything on earth could make them. Matthew 17:2, Mark 9:3, and Luke 9:29. Matthew 17:2, and was transfigured before them, and his face did shine as the sun, and his raiment was white as the light. Mark 9:3, and his raiment became shining, exceeding white as snow, so as no whitener on earth can white them. Luke 9:29, and as he prayed, the fashion of his countenance was altered, and his raiment was white and glistering. This was caused by a force field put around him to protect the body that he was using from the heat and effects of the spaceship. Then, after God finished speaking to Jesus, a bright cloud came over the disciples, and the cloud of smoke engulfed them. Luke 9:34. While he thus spoke, there came a cloud and overshadowed them, and they feared as they entered into the cloud. And God said, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear him. Matthew 17:5. While he yet spoke, behold, a bright cloud overshadowed them, and behold, a voice out of the cloud which said, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear ye him. How then can Christ, the Spirit within the man, not be the Son of God, when God himself said so? God never lies. Lies are Lucifer the devil's invention. John 8:44, King of Kings Bible, John 8:35. You are of your father the devil, and the lusts of your father will you do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaks a lie, he speaks of his own, for he is a liar, and the father, inventor of it. Jesus said, You must not be priests, Matthew 23:8, and you must not listen to priests, Matthew 15:14, 16:12, 23:9, 13, and 24. Matthew 23:8. Be ye not called priest, etc., for one is your teacher, even Christ, and all ye are brethren. Matthew 15:14. Let them alone, they be blind leaders of the blind, and if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch, or pit. 16:12. Then understood they how that he bade them not beware of the leaven of bread, but of the doctrine of politicians, and of those who believe not the prophets, and the hereafter. Matthew 23:9. And call no man your father upon the earth, for one is your father, which is in heaven. But woe unto you, lawyers, and politicians, hypocrites, Pharisees, Persian converts to Judaism, who were the politicians, hypocrites. For ye shut up the kingdom of heaven against men, For ye neither go in yourselves, neither allow you them that are entering to go in. See King of Kings Bible, Enoch 93:4-104:6. But go into your closets in private to speak to God and do His will. He said that you must do and live the Lord's Prayer, Matthew 6:9-15. Not just repeat it like a silly parrot that does not understand what it is saying, and that includes the singing of hymns and the communal or individual saying of written prayers. Matthew 6:9-15. After this manner, therefore pray ye, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts and trespasses, if we truly repent, as we forgive our debtors and those who trespass against us, if they truly repent. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. For if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. Repeating written prayers once a week or up to 5 times a day is no good, because the rest of the time you are automatically talking to Satan. Matthew 6:7. But when ye pray, use not vain repetitions, as the heathen do, for they think that they shall be heard for their much speaking. Praying means talking to God mentally, telepathically, 24 hours a day, every day, and consulting Him on everything and getting His guidance and help to enable you to be able to do His will. Surah 42:38, Ephesians 6:18, and 1 Thessalonians 5:17. Surah 42:38, those who hearken to their Lord and establish constant prayer, who conduct their affairs by mutual consultation with the I Am, who spend out of what we bestow on them for sustenance. Ephesians 6:18. Praying constantly, without ceasing, with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto, with all perseverance and supplication for all holy people. 1 Thessalonians 5:17. Pray without ceasing. Initially, it will be a conscious effort, but eventually, when you have had enough practice, it will become as natural and unconscious an effort as breathing. If you are not actually talking, you must still continue to listen and acknowledge His presence and the contact, keeping the line open. The moment you break or allow the contact to be broken, you are allowing an opening for Satan to use, and he will jump straight in with both feet. Christ foretold of His second coming to His disciples at the Last Supper. He told them that He had many things still to tell them, but that they could not bear to hear them yet. John 16:12. I have yet many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. But that the time would come, His second coming, when He would not talk in proverbs or parables, and would show them clearly about God. John 16:25 and Revelation 10:7. John 16:25. These things I have spoken unto you in proverbs, but the time cometh when I shall no more speak unto you in proverbs, but I shall show you plainly of the Father. Revelation 10:7. But in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God should be finished, as he hath declared to his servants the prophets. He said the second coming would be at a time when they would not think that he was coming, Luke 12:40, and that he would enlighten the whole world, Matthew 24:27, Luke 17:24-37, and Revelation 10:7. Luke 12:40. Be ye therefore ready also, for the Son of Man cometh at an hour when you think he will not. Matthew 24:27. For as the lightning cometh out of the east, and shineth even unto the west, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Luke 17:24. For as the lightning that lighteneth out of the one part under heaven, shineth unto the other part under heaven, so shall the Son of Man be in his day. But first must he suffer many things, and be rejected of this generation. And as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the days of the Son of Man. They did eat, they drank, they married wives, they were given in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and the flood came and destroyed them all. Likewise also shall it be in the days of Lot. They did eat, they drank, they bought, they sold, they planted, they builded. But the same day that Lot went out of Sodom, it rained fire and brimstone from heaven, and destroyed them all. Even thus shall it be in the day when the Son of Man is revealed. In that day, he which shall be upon the housetop, and his stuff in the house, let him not come down to take it away, and he that is in the field, let him likewise not return it back. Remember Lot's wife. Whosoever shall seek to save his life shall lose it, and whosoever shall lose his life shall preserve it. I tell you, in the night that there shall be two men in one bed, the one shall be taken, the other shall be left. The two women shall be grinding together, and one shall be taken, and the other left. The two men shall be in the field, and one shall be taken, and the other left. And they answered and said unto him, Where, Lord? And he said unto them, Wheresoever the body is, there will the eagles be gathered together. Revelation 10:7. But in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God shall be finished, as he hath declared to his servants the prophets, and that God's truth, gospel, must be published amongst all the nations. Mark 13:10. And the gospel must first be published among all nations. He said the churches and their riches would be demolished. Luke 21:5-6. And as some spoke of the temple, how it was adorned with goodly stones and gifts, he said, As for these things which ye behold, the day will come, in the which there shall not be left one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down. And that all real and practicing believers of all nations, who had the mark of God in their forehead, direct communication with God, would survive the last day. Luke 13:29. And they shall come down from the east, and from the west, and from the north, and from the south, and shall sit down in the kingdom of God. Do you have the mark? Jesus left a question about the second coming. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man comes, shall he find faith on earth? Luke 18:8. I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, shall he find faith on earth? What do you think? Is there faith left on earth today? Jesus said, If any man does God's will, God will prove to him whether Jesus' teachings are true or whether Jesus has made them up himself. John 7:17. If any man will do his will, he shall know the doctrine, whether it be of God or whether I speak of myself. You have had 2,000 years to test his teachings and find out if they are true, and yet you are still here. Why? Why? The Bible is not just a book of nice stories. It contains the Old Covenant and the New Covenant, contract, testament, and is a map for your spiritual journey of self-perfection. You have to become Abraham to begin the journey, then become Isaac, Jacob, Israel, Joseph, Moses, the prophets, and then finally Jesus.